Let's see.
Oh. Very nice, very nice. Most definitely best angle available. Right there. Let's see. So it works. So got the Superior. It's got a Lion logo. Down alternative, all season comforter. King size 90 inch, 108 inches. That's 90 by 108. Plush microfiber down alternative fill. All right. Review. This is my first down comforter. Nice weight. I wouldn't even know. The only times I've ever felt one of these is at other people's houses. Okay, already I know that this is not for me. Just by feeling it. But maybe that's premature. Because there's a specific feeling that I want. And this is definitely not it. Unless it is. Because, yeah, it's not that fluffy. Like, it's a down comforter. But it's not. I haven't tried it yet. Like, it's not puffy. It's not puffy. It's gotta be returned. Yeah, no. Alright, review over.
Let's play.
Get a couple. I also got a new cord, one that won't continuously unplug. Oh my gosh, this could have cost $100 and it would have been worth it. With that kind of problem, are you kidding me? Like a cord that will simply not budge. If you can guarantee that, that's worth at least $15, right? Was that dishonorable? Hitting him in the back? You know what? Oh, this. I'm gonna just R2 the entire time. Okay? This entire battle is gonna be an R2. Stalwart to woo your.
Damn it!
I should have gone with the Egyptian. Whatchamacallit? I haven't slept in it. I'm sure it's warm and comfortable, but there's a specific use and feeling that I was looking for. So this next fight, we have to land the swap. And I'm not that good at it. This is new. He doesn't know. Even without the Leo ring, I mean, I don't even think that any of that would have counted as a maybe. Any part of it was a counter, but it's not needed. It's nice though. Let's be honest. Let's play with the honest as Y-hander. The Great Lens is just, it's too good. Oh, well, this guy's whatchamacallit, bow hacking or whatever. I don't know what he was doing, but he definitely looked like he was doing some kind of bug glitch. Bullshit. I don't like it. You know what? That's enough of this. No more multiplayer. You know what the mistake is? So this is the fix right here. The Pokeball is supposed to protect the integrity of the connection here, because I think that's my problem. Like, I would continuously put the controller down and loosen it with each time I put it down. So if I do this, there's no strain. There's no fight. You know. Everybody's happy. I got a Pokeball. Charmander. I've been playing some Demon Souls on the PS3. In fact, yeah, if I had a capture card, I could stream that shit. But alas. Would that be cool? Like streaming Demon Souls, but the PS3 version. While the all right, let's get serious. Let's close a few programs. If we're being serious here. Bam. We want more of those bricks. Why not, you know? I'm gonna rename this thing. It's not worth renaming right now. Mm-hmm. Why do I have my boots on? No. I'm fast as fuck. Oh shit, shit. Let's just, you know, like, who cares? This is harvest season. If you didn't make it in the... Okay, so those are still obviously not ready. Like, this one is not ready, see? This one is. Anyway. Nice. Still enough to proceed. Let's just, you know. I need to create, what is that thing, the chunk loader. I need to have a chunk loader here at all times because I want a lot of this. You see how pretty this block is? This block is freaking gorgeous, man. Look at this. Very nice. We want to put some melons right here. You know what? It's time. Actually, not. Should we? Let's just go mine for diamonds, man. You know what? This is how many diamonds I have. I have 3 diamonds. That's not a good feeling. Figure this out. So I finally have this item thanks to that update, whatever. All right, dude, this is over. We're done with this. All right, we have to put these special shoes somewhere, and I need my special. All right, dude, bam. Super special, very special items. Yeah, we're going for gold right now. We don't have our silk touch. I don't even know where that is. That is it. What do we need? We need those shoes. Yep. I need to put unbreaking on this. This is simply what's not gonna happen. Are there shoes here with unbreaking? Safe about. I've never done this. Let's just do this. to remember that this is not what I need to do here. Let's do that. What is Aqua Affinity again? What other things do I need? And these are just if I go to the Nether. All right, cool. We got the pickaxes. Cool. We can put the shovel away. Place because it really doesn't need to be here. I'll leave one stack there. So when we're mining, we need a chest that says is there a comma there? Let's look this up. Just kidding, that's a joke. Let's just put soul sand kind of everywhere. Like, because this stuff is going to increase our survivability. Like, if I need to get out of a place, I can just place down soul sand and, like, get a quick boost. It's very true. Alright, let's go put all the stuff in its rightful place. Saying So just keep making blocks. Died running this, but it's all good. Like, come on. This is the best looking path available. I didn't want to mess up because I don't want to hurt any of this because I know I can't pick it up right now. Like I'm simply going too fast to register that I want to pick up what I just broke. It'll just be left in my wake. Unless I plan to go right back, I suppose. I messed up with my colors here. Everything in its rightful place. Let's take that. Leave that. Let's take this. This. Stay true to what this is all about. Take all this. Bam. This. These are blocks. Glowstone. These are all blocks that are related to that kind of stuff. So, you know, just kind of drop this miscellaneous stuff here, like. That should have gone there, but whatever. Okay, cool. We got sticks, extra arrows. Oh my gosh, we're so ready. We don't need the chests. All right, we're gonna mine right here. Some stuff away that I forgot to put away. What in God's name is going on over here? I'm looting. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. I can finally get enough slimes. No, here. Okay, I got 1, 2, 3. Ooh, 6. Nice. like, we're just... This place has to be completely... Complete. And this is efficiency 5 right here. Like, it does require that this completely gets taken out. I need to look up how to do a beacon, because this area is going to get mined out. Let me figure out. Because I could just do a beacon here. That's exactly what I should do. I have so much iron. Okay, I don't want a let's play. I just want a quick, easy tutorial on...
What's going on, guys? Katie here, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to craft a beacon in Minecraft and how you use them. Let's get started. Alright, to craft a beacon, we're going to need 3 obsidian, 5 glass, and a nether star. Now that's pretty hard to get, so why don't we do that first?
A nether star?
So, to get a nether star, we're just going to go ahead and go on into the nether and find ourselves a nether fortress. Which shouldn't be that hard, right?
A nether fortress, I know where that's...
What we're looking for in this nether fortress is wither skeletons. We're going to kill them with our Living 3 sword, so that we can get their skulls and summon the Wither. Once we summon the Wither and kill him, we'll get our Nether Star that we need to make our beacon. While we're in the Nether, we're going to want to go ahead and collect 3 buckets of lava, so that we can turn them into obsidian and make our beacon. There we go. We actually got 2 from them, so we're going to be doing pretty good. Now we can go back to the overworld and go ahead and summon the Wither. But we're going to need one thing first. Before we can summon the Wither, we're actually going to have to get just about 4 soul sand. And, I almost forgot, we're going to need to fill up these other 2 buckets too. Now we can go back and summon the Wither using all of these items we just collected. When you're fighting the Wither, you're going to want to go underground, because it's the easiest to corner him and he won't fly away and shoot at you all menacingly and mean. Alright, I went ahead and dug myself underground and blocked off the passageway up so that no mobs can come and kill me. Now I'm going to go ahead and summon my Wither and stand as far back as I can.
What the hell did I just put that shit?
Now you want to make sure when you're fighting the Wither to have Smite on your sword. It'll give you double the damage buff as sharpness against the Wither, seeing as he's undead. Alright, let's start this one. That didn't take long at all, but I'm nearly dead. Let's go ahead and eat some golden carrots, which give you the most saturation, and will heal you up the most after eating them. So they're just about the best food for the job. Let's take this nether star back up to our house. Alright, before we can craft our beacon, there's about 2 more things we're gonna have to do. First of all, we're gonna have to take these buckets of lava and dump them in this little pond. That'll turn them into obsidian so that we can mine that and use that for our beacon. Next, we're going to have to go collect some sand so that we can actually make the glass for our beacon. And we're going to need about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of sand, because we're going to need 5 pieces of glass. This will be just about it, and we can go cook this glass up and make ourselves a beacon. Alright, now that our glass is done smelting, we can go ahead and craft ourselves a beacon with just some glass, our nether star, and our obsidian. Now that we got our beacon, all we have to do is go outside somewhere, place it down. Nothing happens. That's because we actually have to build a pyramid for it out of valuable resources such as emeralds, diamonds, gold, or iron for it to even function at all. Alright, now that I got some iron blocks, let's go ahead and build up a 1-layer pyramid for it, and we'll place it on top. And there we go. Now we can open it up, and if we have some iron bars in our inventory, we can go ahead and activate the 2 effects we have available for the first tier of beacon, and that's speed and haste. I prefer speed, so we'll go ahead and do that.
Wait, that last part?
And there we go. Now we can open it up, and... And if we have some iron bars in our inventory, we can go ahead and activate the two effects we have available for the first tier of beacon. And that's speed and haste. I prefer speed, so we'll go ahead and do that. Now, this will go 20 blocks in each direction from your beacon. So, not the best range, but it's still pretty good. Reach about right here. To increase the radius of our beacon and get access to some more of these valuable buffs, we're going to have to build our beacon up accordingly. And if we get it to the highest tier, which is 4 layers of blocks, we can either add regeneration to whatever effect we choose, or get the second level of that effect, which is pretty cool. Something to keep in mind when you're building your beacons is that the different types of blocks don't actually change the effect of your beacon or the radius. Likewise, putting a different type of item in here to activate it also won't change what you get. They're just different options. Now that we built our beacon up to the max level, it's got a range of 50. The range increases by 10 for each layer, starting at 20 for the first, 30, 40, and then finally 50. Now that we built our beacon, we can go ahead and put an iron ingot in, or any of these items, select our buff, and either select regeneration to the first tier, or select the second tier standalone. And there we go. Now we've got speed 2 to run around our house as fast as we please. Something else that is cool about beacons is you can actually color your beam by placing stained glass on top of it. And if you want your own custom color, you can actually mix different colors. Like red and green makes bad. Another cool thing you can do is get some glass panes, and you can actually place them inside the beam, so you don't have ugly glass obstructing you. You can also mix these just like you can mix the glass blocks. And you can make some ugly colors with them too. Alright, if you guys like this video, make sure to hit like, get subscribed, and comment down below what you guys think I should do next. I'll see you guys next time.
I just feel like mining. I need new lava boots. Oh, this is with the obsidian. Never.
I'm looking for my sister.
I heard she's with the white NJ fighting ISIS.
Coming here was the big mistake.
I'm looking without my sister.
This is more one.
Every day is another chance to make it happen. That's why I don't wait until Monday.
Oh, very nice. Incredible.
Hello everyone, my name is Pixorix and welcome back.
Okay, there's lava here somewhere. Very good vein. What? Oh shit. I don't want to risk it at all. Like, I'm gonna get all this magma, dude. Dude. I've lost diamonds this way. Like, I was like, oh, okay, it's not that deep. Whatever, whatever. And so, it begins. The magma, pyroclastic flow. We We have more iron for sure somewhere. Nice. This is actually the perfect amount. Just gonna make sure we don't have more. I like this. I really do like this mechanic of like, oh, make sure you have this type of armor or this item to deal with this enemy, you know? Because it, yeah, just to whatever it takes to get more slimes. Worst slime farm ever. It just goes too deep, dude. It's gonna burn my fucking diamonds. This is a full blast. You know what? Dang, yeah, I was making stone slabs here. take this elevator. Very slow, very slow. Nice. You know what? Depth Strider is the enchantment, not Feather Falling. God, there's just so much lava. I'm gonna come over here with so many buckets right now. I'm literally going back to my base. Going straight there. Shoes down there. Oh shit. Is what we do. We'll kill a bunch of our fucking cows. Doesn't matter. Gotta be netherrack here. There's definitely a population here that's out of control. Unless I don't know. I'm gonna leave literally two. What do we want a lot of? time I come around, you guys better all be full grown. Do these guys? No. Some of them are gone. These guys?
No, we go.
Thank you. we can do? Just do a bunch of... Does this work? Let's see. Polished. Much wool from killing him, it looks like. Yeah, we could just do cobblestone, that's fine. Does it, water turn one into cobblestone? Like, I haven't really messed around with it. If I turn it to obsidian, I'm not sure. Because then that would be an issue. How do I have less than 6 buckets now? That is hilarious, dude. How is that possible? Did I put buckets up? Like, did I forget buckets, man? Buckets in the other thingy. Yeah, you see that? my guy. You motherfucker. Fucking jerk. That was so scary. Wait, is there possibly on the other side? Diamonds, dude. Damn. That was worth it, though. And that's the way it's supposed to be done, I think. Oh, man. What a day. Oh, I should have killed him. If I had killed him. I should put a hopper right here and see what happens. So 15 diamonds. Okay, we're gonna go get some real armor. It's only 5 o'clock. We can make more coffee. I didn't make myself coffee. Damn, a down comforter. I may keep it and get another one. But that would be a waste of money. BRB, we get some coffee. greatest decision ever. I am saying, I am liking the way that this comforter looks, though. I'm being real, but being honest. So now we can make some armor, which is good. So what we want to do is organize. Just put this stuff right here. Don't get too crazy. My sacred diamond's with us. Put our fast as fuck shoes on. Maybe I'll harvest it one day when I know I'm gonna go look real quick there and back. That's just bomb. Harvest time for these guys, though. Right? Fortune. I haven't even tried soul soil yet. So we're enchanting. Except we don't have enough. Then that means things. Let's go get levels in the Nether and look for that that thingy. The best power. This is good. Let's take this right now. I can save on the This is the Nether way. Thank you. do? We forget about that past. We forget about it. Make a new path. Right here. It's telling us. What's up, dog? What's up, homie? This is where it needs to go to, right here. This is going to be a soul sand pathway. So, what's probably most important is the side block. Thank you. This is so necessary. Oh, I think that's the ancient material. That's the stuff. Right? No. It just looks different than I'm putting it down. Does it look the same on the side? I guess so. There's already a structure here, huh? No boat? Do we We had a stop on the left. That's it. And a trap door. Let's where did I put the bricks? No, let's not put nether bricks, but we could put the red nether bricks. This. That'd be cool. Okay, so this is a good time to get the netherrack from the cave. Thank you. Mercs are down here, I'm pretty sure. Oh, slime. Worst farm in existence. Do I run slower with them on? Oh hell yeah. Okay, let's literally pass out. There's the bucket. Cool. bunch of bricks. And this harvest might be ready. Yep. Let's just sleep outside. I didn't collect the nether wart on the way back. I hope it's still there on that pathway. I'm sure it is. There are some items that are just that just never seem to despawn. Souls. I love this so much. When I heard about this, I came back to the game. I was like, you know what? I've always wanted to move very fast. We gotta use this soon. Store up another wart on the horsey. Now we run across and hope our items are still there. Unless I picked them up. Nope. So they despawned or I picked them up. Pretty good. Not bad. A stack. Thank you. One more just to be safe. Two more just to be safe. Let's just do it from right here, dude. Stuff like that. Thank you. I know there's stones over here. It's because I went digging. Over here, I'm pretty sure. For pouches, because I always want to bring like a variety. What slabs are better here? Actually, there are stones, correct? Some arrows. There's a small stack of slabs here. They were not good. Actually. I want slabs. What I do is this and get and then because the slabs won't be enough for to go slabs. Just in case we have a few. And this too. So we got our bow. F. Let's put that in E. F. This is our E. So where's our diary? The pirate's log. Thank you. This should be a slab.
Thank you.
Wow, I feel so slow. I know I like this area. I want to look up the coordinates right now. Do that gold dog. Do that gold. This is exciting though. I have the fortress. I'm getting somewhere finally in this game. Guys on site. So this has everything, but we want it to be a silk touch. because we already have one of these. This is efficiency 4. Dark Souls snakes. Oh man. That's cool, man. But this one needs Silk Touch. But I already have this one. Dang, this is a good one. This is also good. Best enchantment. Fortune 3, efficiency 5, silk touch, unbreaking. Mending's cool. Can I put mending on? At least? Do I have mending? Aqua affinity and efficiency. Put the shovel away. This is really nice. Ooh, get me out of this fucking stupid ass website. Should have more of these somewhere. I did a bunch of villager trading. Okay. Let's look at our list of things to do. Okay, we did the mine diamonds. If I had melon seeds. Let's go see if we could plant some of these pumpkins. Away. Two shovels that are a fucking bomb. think you need a name tag. What we could put on this hoe? Efficiency and fortune. Right? Nice. Ten motherfucking points, dog. Get that in a jiffy. You know what we're gonna do? Get lost. I completely forget. This goes up, right? And this goes down. Dang, put a lot of food too. Thank you. bring those just in case. Touch those for now on. From my hole with me. I completely forgot what I was gonna do. I'm gonna stop using a scroll wheel. Some fucking noob shit. Thank you. you know? How are you feeling about this? Where are we? Where are we? We're at 8. Wasted one. Could have got 4 of that one. Thank you. it only got 4 out of 4 blocks each time. The other time I got freaking almost like 15 or 10. I don't know. Are these like mites coming to kill me? That I kind of set the stage to only get 4 out of that. Where do I want to go? I wanted to get 10 levels, right? And we need Death Strider. This is the good one. This is good for that. So when you're mining, you need We needed a 10 to do something. Oh, the unbreaking hoe. We might be able to get 10 from this. I'm just going to go straight to the nether. Move my goal. Yep. Let's take some... what's just the word? I like this stuff in the Nether actually. It's got good contrast. Blast furnace? Do I have one here? I don't think we have a blast furnace over there. Small stone furnace and 5. last one. Just take this. Soul speed dog. Soul speed 3. Do I not have gold on me right now? Dude, I always need to have gold. Let's bring a bunch of books. Green pants. of armor there.
Thank you. quick, I'd like to say that 89% of you viewing are not subscribed. I mean, last week it was 99%, so a 10% increase in a week is really good, but we're really close to 4,000 subscribers, and you can help us get there. So you'll want to start out by digging out an area around your blaze spawner and building 4 blocks in all 4 flat directions away from the spawner. You'll want to build down 6 more blocks underneath the spawner and build a glass platform that fits within the X you built on the spawner. When you have that finished, you want to build up glass walls on each side that reach 1 block above the spawner. And then you also want to place a slab or something on top of the spawner so the blazes can't get stuck on top of it. Now you'll want to build out 10 blocks from each corner in every horizontal direction. I accidentally built out 11 for some reason, but you should do 10, not 11. And after that, you want to build 7 blocks down from all these corners. So now if you imagine a perfect cube fitting around everything you just built, everything inside of it should be air, aside from the blocks you just put there. If anything in there is not air, this can severely affect the farm. Now that you have everything cleared out, you want to take away 3 of these guys you built. You only want 1 corner left. You'll want to fill in this corner with whatever solid block you have and build it all the way up to just below the glass. You'll want to remove one of the columns of glass that's touching your blocks and extend the block out 1 more in that direction. You'll want to dig out a 3 block high entryway with...
Yeah, this is not worth doing. I don't even know what this is really for potions, right? I need to come back with some better armor. Fire protection potion on. Did it stop working? Thank you. I'm so excited for my new pens.
Two block high corridors in each direction. You'll want to cover everything in trapdoors so that if a blaze goes in there, they just fall straight down. If you're worried about things spawning in these little holes, you can put a button or something there.
The thing about this guy is that, like, you can...
Next is the suffocation unit. You want to build a sticky piston like I have here, and then trap it off with trapdoors or stairs or something, and then build a platform to stand on.
And, or he doesn't do
so real quick, remember when we had these things here? You're actually supposed to leave that here and build it down to that. I didn't build it all the way down. I stopped here in the video, but just know that if you want this to work a lot faster, you want to build this whole other chunk on the bottom as well. Behind the piston, you want to make room for 6 comparators in series with a button. I think it's easier just to pause and look to see what this is.
This guy's so good at Minecraft, though.
For the collection system, you're going to put a double chest with a hopper underneath where the blazes will land. You're going to put a slab on top of the hopper so that you can only see the blaze's feet. Next, you'll want to expand the platform a little bit and add another button. We're going to chain redstone torches up all the way past the glass. Now, just below the spawner, you want to fill everything with a sign. Now you want to connect your torches to a dispenser right above the spawner that has lava in it. If you pour lava on top of the spawner, you can prevent blazes from spawning, thus turning off the farm if you need to. And now you'll want to expand the block one more in both inner directions. So now if you press the button and wait, the piston is perfectly timed to leave all the blazes in there with half a heart. And finally, if you thought this video was helpful, if you leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and watch another one of my videos next, you can severely help this channel grow. Like, that's actually how it works. Like, actually.
Fairlife is milk that gives you more. It's ultra-filtered for 50% more protein and 50% less sugar. This holiday, bring more to the table.
Do I get it?
With Fairlife ultra-filtered milk.
Shit, I miss skateboarding. Nah, whatever, I don't really feel like it anyway. Tomorrow will be better. Wait. 25 things you didn't know were craftable in Minecraft?
Getting something. My first build ever was actually made using lots of brick. I loved it. It was really hard to come by. And if you forget, the recipe is very, very simple. Let's get rid of that. It is just 4 bricks in the crafting table. You could do this even not in a crafting table. You could do this in just in your inventory. And that is how you make the humble brick. Moving on to quartz. We got chiseled quartz and we have quartz pillars. Both of these obviously craftable. We're doing a list of craftable things. It'd be silly to do blocks that you can't craft yourself. These are very simple, but kind of easy to forget how to actually make them. For the pillar, that is the one with the stripes at the top. This just requires 2 blocks on top of each other, and you get get 2 blocks, so it's a 1-for-1 ratio. For the chiseled, we need to first make our quartz into slabs, which is simple, either doing that, and then take those slabs and place them on top of each other, and then you get 1 block as the output, and it has that cool little design on it right there. Next, moving on to prismarine blocks, and we have a whole family of prismarine blocks here. First, I don't think people realize that they can craft these at all. They forget that all the time. They almost always harvest these blocks from already found ocean monuments where the Elder Guardians have been destroyed or killed, so that you don't get the mining fatigue and you can mine these up. Pro tip, you can now use TNT quite effectively to destroy all the blocks, because TNT now has 100% drop rate when destroying blocks. You just need to make sure that there's no water hitting the TNT, but you could effectively destroy all the blocks in a ocean monument if you got rid of all the water first, which may be more of a hassle than that is worth, just to do it without the Elder Guardian around. But here has how to craft all of these. I just have a whole bunch of each. First is prismarine, this basic prismarine right here. It almost looks like prismarine cobblestone. That is a 4, just 4, so a 2x2 to get that prismarine out. Next is the prismarine bricks. So those are those cool little things that almost look like scales. That requires 9, so that is a 3x3. And then let's go for the dark prismarine. That is an interesting one because it still uses an ink sac in its recipe. I would have thought that it would be black dye, but that doesn't work. It has to be an ink sac in the middle, and that will get you dark prismarine. The crystal right there.
I want a small garden farm.
A place to make a quick buck. Give to our communities to gain.
and 4 obsidian. That's a lot. Be right back, yo. Got a snack. Nice. I did my close. Put a timer. I do like the way it looks, though. Looks clean.
Muscle milk helps build muscles, but not the one that matters most.
Switch this to Twitch. So we can play music.